Okay guys, so in this video here, I'm just going to explain how one actually sets up and uses the four-volume set of the Liturgy of the Hours. You'll also hear one volume referred to as the breviary, is what's more commonly referred to as. I'm just going to show you how to place your ribbons, where they should be set, and when you're going to flip to what ribbon as we pray the Liturgy of the Hours here in community. There's four different volumes here that you see. So you'll have the Advent and Christmas season, the Lent and Easter season, and then you have two volumes for ordinary time, weeks 1 through 17, and then weeks 18 to 34. I'm just going to go ahead and set up one volume in this video because they're all set up the same way. So once you set up one, it transfers over to all the others. And I'm just going to go ahead and look at the fourth volume of Ordinary Time, 18 to 34, because I'm currently in the 19th week of Ordinary Time. So let's go ahead and just look at that one. Okay, guys, so if you want to go ahead and open up one of your volumes, again, I'm using the fourth volume here for weeks 18 to 34 of Ordinary Time, and go ahead and open up to the table of contents at the beginning. We're just going to go ahead and do a brief overview of the different sections that are in the breviary so that you just have a general understanding of the terms that we're using. Don't worry if you don't understand the terms or what they mean exactly now. You'll come to know that later. So long as you kind of know where your ribbon is placed and when you're supposed to flip to it, that's really all you need to know now. The rest will come, but we're just going to go through it so you have a kind of a familiarity with the terms that we're going to be using. So the first section you'll see here we're going to look at is the proper of seasons. So this section of the breviary is just going to have all of the prayers that are proper to the specific season of the liturgical year that we are in. So since I am in the fourth volume here, Ordinary Time, you'll see that all of the sections below that are associated with that week of the season that I'm in. So all the way from the 18th week in Ordinary Time through the 34th week in Ordinary Time. So all the prayers associated with that week will be located there. And then you'll also find some solemnities, such as the Solemnity of Christ the King, for example, will fall within that season. So those are located here in a different section. And then you'll see we have the Ordinary of the Liturgy of the Hours. The Ordinary is essentially the instructions for how one prays the specific hour that you are currently praying. And it will also have prayers that are repeated every day during that hour so that they don't have to be reprinted over and over. So for example, in morning prayer, you will always be praying the Canticle of Zechariah. So instead of reprinting the Canticle of Zechariah over and over and bulking up your book, they just print it on one page. You'll set a ribbon to that and then flip to it whenever you come to that part in morning prayer. And so after the Ordinary of the Hours, you get to the bulk of what you're going to be praying in the breviary, and that's going to be the Psalter. The Psalter is split up into 4 weeks that you'll pray, and that consists of your psalms and canticles and readings and intercessions that you're going to be praying during morning prayer, evening prayer, daytime prayer. But you'll see night prayer is located within its own section. And that's just because like every Monday of the week, night prayer is always the same, every Tuesday, Wednesday, etc. And that's the same for every season. So your night prayer ribbon that we would set is going to be the same throughout all four volumes. So if you're in Ordinary Time or Easter, night prayer is pretty much always the same, minus, you know, a couple of Alleluias in the season of Lent or added additionally in the season of Easter. It's pretty much the same. And then after the Psalter, you see that we have the proper of saints. So we had the proper of seasons here, all the prayers proper to the season of the liturgical year. Now we have the proper of saints. So in the proper of saints, you're going to find all of the feast days, memorials, and solemnities associated with the saint of the day according to the month of the year that you are in. So for example, yesterday was August 15th and we celebrated the solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. So the proper of saints told us where to find the prayers associated with that day. And it then directed us to the section of the commons here. The commons is just prayers that will commonly be used on different feast days. So you'll find the common of doctors of the church or of virgins or of holy men and holy women. So yesterday, since it was a feast of the Blessed Virgin Mary, it directed us to the common of the Blessed Virgin Mary, which is where we pulled the majority of our prayers from. And there's a couple other sections here in the book that you can familiarize yourself with, but right now we're not going to go through that. Just know that there's a couple other things added in here. So there's a poetry section in the back of the book, a couple of other indexes of psalms and canticles. Those won't be needed when you pray through the Liturgy of the Hours. But we're going to go ahead and set up our first ribbon so that we can begin to familiarize ourselves with how one flips back and forth in this book. So the first section we discussed here was the proper of seasons, and that's going to be where we place our first ribbon. Doesn't matter what color you're using, just as long as it's the first one there, doesn't really matter. They differ when you buy each volume anyways. So you're going to go ahead and find what season, what week of the season you are currently in. You can just do that by doing a Google search, figuring out what season of liturgical year you're in, look at a liturgical calendar, or go to the USCCB website, look at the daily readings, and it will tell you, you know, Monday of the 19th week in ordinary time, or whatever else it is, or the week of Lent, Easter, etc. But I know that I am currently in the 19th week in ordinary time, so I'm going to flip to page 88, and I would set my ribbon there. Let's go to page 88 for the 19th Sunday in ordinary time. So I had set it here on Sunday, and you would continue to flip, and currently I am on a Wednesday, so I have mine set for Wednesday of the 19th week in ordinary time. So just leave that there. We'll kind of understand when we're going to flip to this later, but just go ahead and set that as your first ribbon. The second ribbon, you're going to go ahead and set in the second section that we discussed of the ordinary. So the ordinary, like I said, is kind of the instructions that one might find. So if you, again, you can go to the table of contents and figure out what page this is on in your current volume. But this one begins on page 611 in this volume, and it's the ordinary of Liturgy of the Hours for ordinary time. And so ordinary is going to be used even if you're, you know, in Easter or Lent. Ordinary is not just associated with ordinary time. It's fit for all four volumes. And you'll see that it's always going to begin with the invitatory. The invitatory is always prayed at the first hour of the day, and then you'll find the office of readings, and then it'll go through morning prayer, daytime prayer, evening prayer, and night prayer. All of those instructions and prayers that are common kind of to that section will be found here. And when you come to Brute here, we'll be praying morning prayer, evening prayer, and night prayer together in community each day, depending on the day of the week of our schedule. And then we'll be praying the invitatory on Thursday mornings together, at least with the current schedule that we have set up here. And when one comes to Brute, one is not expected to be praying all of these hours every day right when you are introduced to Liturgy of the Hours. You know, we won't be expecting you to pray the invitatory, the office of readings, morning prayer, daytime prayer, evening prayer, and night prayer each day. A priest, you know, has made a vow to pray those hours each day, every day, and a lot of religious orders do the same, and the laity has been encouraged to pray the Liturgy of the Hours. But when one is first being introduced to the Liturgy of the Hours, one is not expected to pray all of those right from the get-go. You know, seminary especially is a process of gradualism, and the spiritual life, you know, is more of a marathon than it is, you know, a sprint. And so it's about slowly adding these hours into your prayer life as you, you know, grow in love of our Lord and get more comfortable with it and more familiar with it in your prayer life. And so have that conversation with your spiritual director of, you know, how to add these into your prayer life. And generally our rector, you know, might say that, oh, you know, maybe pick, you know, 2 hours to do, you know, well, in addition to, you know, we'll obviously be praying, you know, certain hours in common, but, you know, maybe in addition to those, you know, on your free time or when you're home on break, you know, maybe pick 2 hours of like morning prayer and night prayer, or morning prayer, evening prayer, and just kind of start small with it and build up and, you know, be talking to your spiritual director. And as you grow in your spiritual life and mature, these will all kind of be added into your spiritual life. And throughout the 6 to 10 years that you're here in seminary, by the time you get to your diaconate, you'll be praying the Liturgy of the Hours for quite some time. And just remember, you know, adding more vocal prayers and more devotions to your prayer life is maybe not what you're needing at this exact time to grow, you know, in love of our Lord and to grow in your spiritual life. So just talk with your spiritual director about adding these in. But for right now, we'll just go ahead and set our ribbon in the ordinary to morning prayer, and then we'll go ahead and set our third ribbon. So we'll go ahead and grab our third ribbon. And again, don't worry too much about when this is going to be used. We'll get to that. We're just going to set our third ribbon. And that will be located in the Psalter. So if I were to go to the beginning of my table of contents again, and I flip to the section known as the Psalter, you'll see that it has a couple of different weeks listed here. I currently know that I am in the third week is what we're using for the Psalter. And you can figure out what week that is by going to your first ribbon. If you were to flip to that, and you'd see the proper of seasons here, and you flipped to the beginning of whatever that is. So I know that mine begins on the 18th week in ordinary time. If I were to go to the first day of Sunday of that week, it will tell you at the top what week you should be setting your Psalter to. So at the beginning here, 18th Sunday in Ordinary Time, telling me my Psalter is set to week 2. So since I'm now on the 19th week of Ordinary Time, I already have it set to the 3rd week. So that's how you can figure out what week of the Psalter you're in. And then once I get to the 20th week, I'd be in the week 4. And then when I get to week 21 of Ordinary Time, I'd flip back to the beginning of the Psalter and restart from week 1. And that will go just on a cycle throughout the season that you're in. So we'll go ahead to the week 3 then, since I'm in the 19th week of Ordinary Time, and I'll set that to Wednesday of morning prayer, since that is where we are at when I'm filming this video. And we'll find our morning prayer section here and set that there. So, all right, we got our main 3 ribbons set. That's typically all you're going to use when you pray Liturgy of the Hours for morning prayer or evening prayer here in community. Those are pretty much what you're going to be flipping between for the most part. But we'll go ahead and set our other ribbons because you will be using these frequently as well. Our 4th ribbon, though, is going to be for night prayer, so not associated with the main bulk of the Psalter here in those 4 weeks. But night prayer, and again, you can find the page in the table of contents to where you set that. You would flip to that and set it for the specific day of the week that you are on. So, for example, today is Wednesday. I have my night prayer set to Wednesday. This is the only section that you're really going to use for night prayer. You're not going to flip anywhere else. At the beginning of this night prayer section, though, so if I were to flip back, you'd see that they have all the hymns located there. So you'll see they have just different hymns that you can select. So the prayer leader will announce what page the hymn is going to be coming from, and then they will begin that hymn at the beginning of night prayer each day. And you'll find here also in the night prayer section that you're going to see an after evening prayer 1 on Sundays and Solemnities, and an after evening prayer 2 on Sundays and Solemnities. In this after evening prayer 1 and 2 is just kind of associated with how Sundays work and the celebrations of the liturgy in the church. So on Saturday, for example, you are able to go to Mass, you know, at 5:30 at your home parish, and that counts as a Sunday Mass because for the Jewish people, you know, their Sabbath was kind of set from not midnight to midnight, but sundown to sundown was how they kind of calculated their days. And that's kind of transferred over to what we have now. But we also do our midnight to midnight cycle. So we just kind of lucked out and I guess kind of had a day and a half of Sunday celebration. So on the evening before is when the Sunday begins at, again, around like 5:30 is why we can, you know, celebrate Sunday Mass then. We do the same thing in this liturgy, in the Liturgy of the Hours. So on Sunday, for example, you're going to pray evening prayer 1 on Saturday. So on Saturday evening, you'll pray evening prayer 1. And then for night prayer, it would be after evening prayer 1 on that Sunday that you're on. And then when it comes to Sunday, you would do, you know, morning prayer, evening prayer. And at the end of the day, you would do after evening prayer 2. On that Sunday. And again, that's also used for solemnities, as it notes here. So yesterday we had the Solemnity of the Assumption. And so since yesterday was Tuesday, on Monday we prayed after evening prayer 1, and then we had the celebration of the Solemnity all the way through Tuesday, and at the end of Tuesday we concluded the celebration with after evening prayer 2 on that Solemnity. So if you ever have a Solemnity and it falls, you know, on one of the days of the week, like a Tuesday, just remember to flip back to the celebration for that Solemnity beginning on evening prayer 1. So that's our ribbon set here. We're going to set that for the day we're on, Wednesday, for night prayer. And then the final ribbon you're going to have here is set to the Proper of Saints. So again, you can go to the table of contents and find the current page that you're going to be on for the month of the year that you're in, and go ahead and set your ribbon on that page. So you'll see that mine here is set to August 15th, which was yesterday. And if I flip through, we'll find that today, August 16th, is the memorial of Stephen of Hungary. So if you were to flip through here, you would just find the days and what memorial is coming up. So the next memorial that I'll have after that would be on August 19th. And you'll also find that these volumes, they're older and kind of outdated as to what saints we've canonized since, you know, these volumes were put out. So you'll find some memorials of some saints that are on the, you know, liturgical calendar that you won't find, you know, here in the proper of saints. But go ahead and set your ribbon there for whatever day you are on, and then we'll go ahead and explain just how one actually will be flipping back and forth in this volume now that we have all of our ribbons set. So when one is coming to morning prayer, for example, since that's what we've just set, you're going to want to go ahead and just double check that your first three ribbons, since those are the ones we're really going to be using, are set to the proper days. So I know today is Wednesday of the 19th week in ordinary time. I have that set. That is only going to have the office of readings for the volume that I am in. So it's not actually really going to be used during morning prayer, but you always just want to have that set as you go through each day. We'll go to our second ribbon then. Make sure that that is set to morning prayer, and it will have, you know, the beginning prayer. So for God come to my assistance is how it will begin with the introductory prayer there, and then it will have the response of the people, Lord make haste to help me. You'll have the doxology, glory to the Father, etc. And then it will continue with the instructions in red to tell you, you know, where to go next. So if you follow this, it would tell you that we'll have the hymn, the appropriate hymn is said. And we'll see that for Sunday and weekday offices, which we are on a weekday now, the hymn is given in the Psalter. So then we would flip to the Psalter to find that hymn. But since we're in ordinary here, we can just go ahead and flip the page, because the next prayer that we're going to need is going to be this canticle here, the Canticle of Zechariah. So we'll just set that to that page so that we can flip to that in a moment. And then we'll go ahead to our Psalter. And we have that now set to the current week that we're on, that again, we found that earlier from the proper of seasons. We'll go ahead and set our ribbon to the current week and day that we're on, Wednesday morning prayer. And that will have that same introductory prayer, God come to my assistance, that we just found in the ordinary. And then after you have the introductory prayer, you will again then find that hymn associated with the day. And it will sometimes give a couple options, you know, and it will separate that with an or. And after you have the hymn, you'll then begin with the psalmody. So if you were to flip to your ordinary, which I said is kind of the instructions of how to pray it, you'd see that that's listed here. You have the introductory prayer, you have the hymn, and then you have the psalmody. And it gives you instructions on all of this here. You'd then have your reading. You'd then have the response to the reading, the gospel canticle, intercessions, etc. You'll find all of that. That's the same order of things that happens here in the Psalter. So we just had our, you know, introductory prayer, we had our hymn, and now we're beginning with the Psalter and the psalmody here. So we'll have basically three psalms or canticles that will be prayed, beginning with the antiphon, the psalm itself, concluding with the same antiphon, antiphon 2, the second psalm or canticle, and then concluding with the second antiphon, and then again with the third antiphon, third psalm, and then the third antiphon. And then, just like it said in the ordinary, the next thing is going to be a reading, the response to that reading, and the responsory here, and then we have that canticle. So that's the antiphon for the canticle. So here at Brute, we would chant this antiphon, and then you would flip to the canticle for morning prayer. You would pray through the canticle, and then you would flip back to again conclude with that antiphon. Sorry, I forgot to move my ribbon. That antiphon there for the Canticle of Zechariah. So it's the same structure as what we just did with the Psalms. We had an antiphon, the Psalm, antiphon. The canticle is just located in a different spot since we're praying that every day. They don't need to reprint it here on that page. And then we have our intercessions that will be located here, led by the prayer leader, and then the reader and the responses all located there for you. And then we have our Our Father, but before one begins the Our Father, it's always preceded with an invitation so that everybody can, you know, begin the Our Father at the same point and you can pray the entire prayer together. And so the prayer leader would also find that invitation here in the ordinary, again, kind of with that instructions. After you have the intercessions, it'll say, all then say the Lord's Prayer. It may be preceded by a brief invitation. You can choose any of those here. So let's conclude our prayers with the Lord's Prayer, and all would begin Our Father, etc. So back here to our page with the Our Father, you'd pray that, and then the prayer leader will do this concluding prayer, and then it will tell you here, now, flip to the ordinary for the conclusion. If you flip back to the ordinary, you'll see, if we flip our page here, it's got the conclusion listed here. May the Lord bless us, protect us from all evil, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Or, in the presence of a priest, you would ask for their blessing. And that would basically be morning prayer. So that is how that would work. And then you could just, you know, kind of leave your ribbons set where they are. But for when you then come to evening prayer later in the day, you could flip to your ordinary here, section for evening prayer. And you'll see again, it's going to have basically the exact same setup. It's going to have that introductory prayer, the hymn, the psalmody, the reading, the response, and then the gospel canticle associated with evening prayer. So that's going to be the Magnificat, beginning with "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord." And then we can go ahead and set our ribbon for evening prayer later when we pray that in community. And again, it will have your opening prayer, your hymn, etc. So pretty much, as you can see, we're only really using those two ribbons for this volume right now. And it will just tell you where to flip. So you'll get the hang of it, but just essentially know that when you begin, just begin with this main third ribbon here. That's where the majority of your prayer is going to be coming from, the third ribbon in the Psalter there. Pretty much everything is going to be coming there. You're going to be following through it. The only time you're really going to flip to a different spot is once you come to whatever canticle you are doing for that hour. So for evening prayer, it's the Canticle of Mary. For morning prayer, it was the Canticle of Zechariah. Flip to the ordinary, find the canticle, flip back. That's really the only time you're going to flip for morning prayer and evening prayer. For different days, you'll find some, it will direct you to different locations. So here's just an example of where it might tell you to flip to a different page. So here it's telling me that if I'm praying the Office of Readings here before morning prayer, it would tell me that the reading and the prayer is in the office of the day. So that would just flip back to the office, which is located in the proper of seasons. You see we have the Office of Readings there, and it would have your readings and prayers located there. So if you ever see the red, just that's where it's telling you to flip. The only other thing you want to know, so on a normal day, again, we're only using the middle ribbon and the second ribbon for the Psalter and the Ordinary. But sometimes you might have the Feast of a Saint appear on that day. So for example, today, August 16th, I'm going to look at this, and it might tell me to pull from a different location. So if I were to look at here, there's a prayer located here that at the end of evening prayer, for example, we saw that it concludes with a prayer, and it has its concluding prayer. One could also take the concluding prayer from the feast of the day. So you always just want to make sure that your ribbon is set to the proper saints. And when you walk into morning prayer, evening prayer, etc., just check and see if there's something different there. So for example, yesterday on August 15th, we're now in the celebration of the Assumption. So I'll go to the first page there so you can see that. We have August 15th is the Assumption. Tells you whether it's a memorial, a feast, or a solemnity. Solemnity being the highest in that order, and then feast and memorial. And then it will give you pretty much all the prayers that you need there. For example, so if we're praying evening prayer 1, which is on the day before August 15th, it would give you the hymn that one is to pray. It would then give you, you know, the antiphon, which we found earlier in the Psalter. Your antiphon is now going to come from here, and now it's going to tell you where all your psalms and canticles are coming from. So it's not going to be on the typical day. You're basically replacing, you know, the middle ribbon there, that Psalter ribbon, with the final ribbon here in the back from the proper of saints. So we do that antiphon, and it's telling us, okay, the Psalms and Canticles coming from the Common of the Blessed Virgin Mary. We talked about the Common earlier. That's going to be on page 1607. You would go to page 1607, and if you have any prayer cards floating around in your room that wonderful people have given to you, this is going to be the time to break them out. I always keep prayer cards in the front of my breviary for occasions like this, where it's going to direct you to a different page. 1607 here, that's the Office of Readings. We're currently doing evening prayer, though, so you would just flip to the evening prayer section and pray that. So you would keep it there, and then again, you'd have to flip back for the antiphon and continue going back and forth. So just make sure you follow with that ribbon. You might get confused the first couple times it happens, but just know that sometimes if there's a feast, it's going to kind of change the normal order of things. But again, the normal order of things, just the middle ribbon for the Psalter and the second ribbon for the Ordinary so that you can get that canticle. So that's essentially how one navigates the breviary for the Liturgy of the Hours, and you'll get more comfortable with it as you go on and get more confident with it. But just know now that you have a general overview of how one navigates the official prayer of the church.